on Full Throttle Saloon.
Penny gave me a green light today on the stunt.
She did? I don't have nothing planned.
So what's your stunt this year?
I just had an idea. I need something shaped like this. Just think Jackal Jaws.
We got the one and only Big and Rich out there tonight in our backyard. And right after, we have the one and only Ben Steele.
The courtyard's empty. The field's empty.
We just lost $100,000.
And tonight.
Man, what a great night we're going to have tonight. It's Jackal Money.
We're going to be wild. Jackal!
Say hello to your little friend!
Showtime just a couple hours away. We got a long way to go and a short time to get there.
What could possibly go wrong?
We got a fight. My hands are wet.
He's running after me.
Silver lining is everything for my stunt is falling into place. Hot damn, this thing is badass. Holy
that is a...
We got to figure it out.
Because it's not any reason for marketing. The only thing I can think about is there's just so much stuff going on.
If Big and Rich had been my grand idea, I don't think Ballard would be taking it quite so easy, because we both just lost $50,000.
We still got the Vince Neil crowd out there. We need to go out there and push shit out of this liquor tonight and make up some of this money.
It's if we don't get this fixed.
Michael keeps saying we have got to make this money up. We don't own that bar. Ballard owns that bar. He gets to damn recoup some of his money tonight with Vince Neil. Me, I'm out my half of the 100K, and it stings.
God, I hate it. Hate it.
How we doing? I need you to push some shots tonight.
I'm going to pull out every promotion that we got to make up for the losses tonight.
Stars are about to go on for the second time tonight. Jesse has really overcommitted us this time.
Where are the four chairs at?
Outside.
And what better way than to say God bless America? Michael Ballard's Full Throttle Saloon, the rock stars out on our stage right now.
Some girls with some really long claws not to get my balls up because of some real chairs.
There was only four up there, and he told me to use them for that stage.
Okay, we just want to make sure that I don't find the other two.
It turns out those red chairs I used to mix it up a little bit belonged to the Jesse James Bourbon Girls, and they were not happy that the rock stars used them.
She's still not being nice because I don't think she knows who I am.
They're really nice to you guys. They tore our heads off.
We're not chairs.
We never took you. I promise you I can afford chairs. They were the ones that were on there. I would not just take your chairs. There was four there, and pretty much any time you're in a situation like this, the best way to handle it is in a professional way.
Right.
And you're not. Look at how you're acting right now. You should be more professional. Take a lesson.
That's my first encounter with Jesse's Bourbon Girls.
He got some real pros there, didn't he?
And you're not going to get very far in this business when you treat people like that.
She's 2 seconds from getting kicked off the property.
I hope that they learn it by maybe tomorrow or the next day.
She has one more chance.
Hey, how many cases of bourbon did we get delivered today for Jesse James?
Those didn't come in today.
That sucks.
Tomorrow night's the Jackal concert. That's Jesse James Bourbon night. It is not the time to be telling me that we're out of the Jesse James Bourbon.
Oh, I'm going to blow a gasket. Them bringing five cases over here tomorrow is not going to get it. That's going to be gone so quick.
This is 100% pure, unadulterated bullshit.
They need to rush order about 100 cases of each product.
Okay, let me just follow up with this and call you back.
Call me back as soon as you can find out something.
Okay.
Thanks.
My man here, dumb drunk. He's been touching on girls.
I've already yelled at him like five times. He's gone. All right, now you're acting stupid.
Tonight's been a wild night. We're spread pretty thin on our volunteers.
Guy fighting right here?
Yeah.
Get up.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Get up.
He's the one who came at me.
Okay, relax then. Who was the one that came at you?
My brother.
Where's your brother at?
Right there.
That dude right there.
Yeah.
You know what happened?
I'm the frame of the family.
You're my voice of reason.
Here. Okay. They're brothers. The other brother is drunk. He's running his mouth off.
Okay.
So we had a couple of brothers in the infield deciding they want to have a family squabble here at the Full Throttle Saloon. One of the brothers got yoked in his face, had a little bit of blood. I get it, man. I got brothers. I got older. I got a younger. The difference is I can take both of them.
What happened?
Hey, this is my brother.
I know it's your brother, but why do you yoke your brother in the face?
Oh, just driving and...
All right. So you had a few too many beers tonight, right?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Hang out right here. I'm going to talk to your brother. I'm going to get you out of here tonight, all right? Cool. It's a brotherly brother. I get it, all right?
The younger brother here was a little bit tougher than the older brother, knocked him on his ass.
Big guy, talk to me real quick. You wanted to press charges against your brother?
No.
I didn't think so. Do you want the ambulance here for that cut on your face?
No.
Do you want my EMT to look at your face?
No.
All right, so you're good to go home?
Yeah.
Did you come here with your brother?
Yeah.
Are you going to fight when I take you off the property?
Yeah, no, I'm
okay,
fine.
Okay, my boys are going to walk him out. You guys are going to give each other a hug and make up. Cool?
That we're not going
to. All right, but you know what I mean.
Watch out for that mud puddle.
Happy birthday, man.
Thank you, Michael.
How old are you?
22.
You know, I put a lot of responsibility on Fajita's plate this year.
Come
here. He can go have a good time with his son tonight, but I've constantly got to keep telling him he's not here to just party.
I hope y'all are slinging some.
Yeah,
no, I'm talking about some food because I wrote a check for $14,000 for up there.
We're in it.
We're in it at $35,000 right now.
Fajita's house killing. I'm telling you, it's murdering it.
All right, so be careful, don't be falling down now. Slide down.
We're not going to be denied a good time tonight. I'm going to show my son one birthday he'll never forget. Hey, getting older hurts.
Yeah, we're back here by the vendor gate. We got intoxicated.
So we had an individual. We asked him to leave numerous times. He decided he didn't want to leave.
Look at me. We're on the property without permission. We asked you to leave three times. You did it. Got you again. Now we're asking you on the property.
You didn't ask me three times.
Yes, we did. Be careful and have a good night.
No, you still come out of the property.
He steps on and he's gone. He's coming back on the property. He's coming back on the property. He's running after me. He's running after me.
Back on.
Well, this has been one hell of a roller coaster ride today. Luckily, Vince Neil brought in a hell of a crowd who rocked the house and made up some ground for us, and our bartenders pushed the out of this liquor. All in all, we might have had a good night.
It's late, I'm tired, burnt out. This day has kicked my ass. Tomorrow is the Jackal night. It's the biggest night of the rally for me. It's got to go off without a hitch. Coming up.
Gonna get you stunt. I got it all figured out.
Trust me, it's all good. You're gonna get what you wanted, though, and it's gonna be badass.
And later.
What the hell are y'all doing?
A really nice man on the internet offered to sell us a flamethrower.
Say hello to my little friend. What could possibly go wrong?
Okay.
I just got a write-off yesterday. I got to move past it and get it behind me. I was so worked up last night, I couldn't even sleep. The silver lining is everything for my stunt is falling into place.
Bring her on.
I rented this giant crane, which is the key component to hoisting the Jackal Jaws and myself up over the crowd.
Can we move this out of the way? Let me try to get this smoker moved. How you doing? You don't know where these fellas are, do you?
Who's that, Cassis?
The smoker guys, yeah.
Oh, I saw one of them around here earlier, but
really?
I don't know where
they are. I just got to get moved forward because I got to be able to get a crane up beside the stage. You know the guy that runs it? You know where? You got a number for them or anything?
Oh, wow.
All right, the guys in the kitchen dropped the ball and didn't move it. I'll move on to plan B. B is in Bobcat.
You reckon Gene Simmons from Kiss ever had to go out and move a smoker before his show? All right. You all right? It's all good. Yeah, you can come on back. Come on.
I'm starting to breathe a little easier now.
Tonight gonna be kicking.
Here's to the full throttle.
Probably about close to 400 people for breakfast. I'm starting running out of everything.
We have a line outside of the door. It's ridiculous.
We need to cut it off for the person. That's it.
Killer breakfast. Come to Full Throttle.
That entire back of that truck is nothing but video screen, and it's going 30 foot up into the air and going to blanket that inside of that courtyard over there.
Really?
Yeah. And we got about 3 or 4 cameras running around broadcasting up on that thing. And yours truly is going to be bigger in life and twice as ugly. See that fence right there?
I need
Ian to get some of the guys to undo that fence so that tractor trailer can come back in here. All right.
This is ridiculous. I told you about 7 o'clock.
Waiting for the food truck.
If you tell me 7, I expected a 7. Otherwise, I would have ordered more the other day, and I would have had extra care and never until the truck got here. I'm about to pull my hair out.
We didn't get our food, Hyde didn't get his food, and Pizza Shack didn't get their food.
Well, if I run out of supplies, I have no customers. With no customers, I lose a ton of money. If Fajita Shack's down, Pizza Shack's down, because you got all the stuff with the damn truck. I don't think Michael Ballard's going to be very happy with that.
He'll be there as soon as he can.
Tell him to hurry the up. I'm losing a bunch of money.
They said, that you had your wife's ashes?
Yes.
Yeah. This is the most intense day of the rally for me, but I'm going to put everything on pause because a fellow biker brother asked me to help him spread his wife's ashes here at the Full Throttle.
And how long ago did this happen?
May the 28th. And we already had plans to come here. She's always wanted to come here, so I figured, you know, what better way to honor her?
Man, it means the world to us that you guys, you know, consider the Throttle family. She left behind a family, 2 children, and obviously left behind a devastated husband as well. This is a beautiful setting right here, and it puts her right beside the Full Throttle. I'm at a loss for words. All I can do is offer a prayer and our hearts out to him and his children. We're here at the Full Throttle Saloon today, sitting beside beautiful Fort Meade underneath a gorgeous blue sky. We now commend these ashes to the earth, and so that Chastity can be at the Full Throttle Saloon where she had always wanted to go, and now she's finally made it. Thanks God to her loving family and her husband who are here with us.
I miss you, baby. Thank you, man.
Sorry for your loss, man.
Thanks.
now Chastity has got a place here at the Full Throttle as well.
Thanks, brother.
All right, well, welcome everybody to Full Throttle Saloon. How y'all doing? It's Thursday. Fans ready to play? Well, man, what a great night we're going to have tonight.
It's Jackal Night here at the Full Throttle Saloon.
Jackal Rock!
Yeah! The way I see it is I'm going to set this thing down, and I keep my straps pretty tight, so you got room to ride in and out without ever hitting a strap.
I brought the crane in because I got this kick-ass stunt for the end of the show, but I've also come up with a great intro. My crane operator, Fritz, he's gonna lift me up from behind the stage sitting on a badass sled custom chopper. He's gonna set me right down in front of that crowd on a platform. It's gonna be the most kick-ass intro ever.
So we're gonna go it with no practice? I like doing things just one time. That's less chance for me to get hurt, right?
I agree.
I don't need to do it. All right.
And so the rock stars are gonna do the moonshine one, but there's gonna be about 20, 25 minutes that I need for the Jesse James Bourbon Girls to get up there and do a show for the bourbon, because that's what today is.
You know, I realized that the Jesse James Bourbon Girls are new to the profession, and we had our little altercation last night, but I'm all about empowering women. And what better way to do that than to have them share the stage with the rock stars?
I just wanna say, like, thank you so much for allowing us to come out here. We respect all of y'all.
Yeah, you're gonna do great.
I just wanna let you know that I'm so grateful. So
I'm really excited,
Thank you. Tonight is the biggest night of the rally. It's Jackal Night. We're very excited to show everybody here at Full Throttle Saloon that FTS has the hottest, most talented women on Sturgis.
Jackal Rocks! This area right here, opened up and rolled back because we gotta get that truck from that gate.
You're touching P right now, you know?
And not mine.
Now put it back. There you go.
I wanna get as close to it as I can.
God, that's badass. Yep. It'd be killer to have one for a backyard barbecue, wouldn't it?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
Chance for the troops.
Go Army!
Three generations in the military.
Thank you, guys.
Full Throttle.
Booyah!
All right, we're saying welcome to the Full Throttle Saloon. Remember, if you come down here in the middle of our hand, we're going to do the tattoo contest. All right, first up, we got Day Day. Next, we have Walker Phoenix. Rick McGuire. And next up is Andrew Beanie. Next up, we have Sammy.
Everything seems to be coming together. My stagehands are busting their ass. They're putting a kabuki up so I can have a curtain drop at the beginning of the show. It's gonna be badass.
You reach it up
all the way?
Sure we can.
Okay.
What the hell?
We're all screaming bloody murder, telling everybody run, get out of the way, the scaffolding's falling.
Is this thing or what?
This front light rig pretty much lights the whole front of the stage. This is essential.
What a shame that is. Worst timing ever for something stupid like that to happen. What a shame.
Is this thing or what?
So that whole thing's coming down?
Yeah. So I get up this morning, bust my ass, trying to get everything in place. The whole concept was to have a big kabuki, which, you know, big curtain in front of the stage, have it drop down and the band come out playing. Now the entire front light rig's got to come down. We don't have any front lights. It's Thursday night, Full Throttle. Why would it be any different?
Hey, what are you and Paige doing right now? Okay, can you meet in Lisa's cabin?
I brought my rock stars down here to talk about a few things for Throttle Fest.
It's a party in here.
It is a party in here. But I actually have some bigger news for them.
Okay, two things, guys. First, we'll perform on Friday the 23rd and Saturday the 24th.
So the other thing I want to tell you about is Michael and I are pregnant.
About it. So as soon as I didn't even get it out, and she was like, I knew it!
So you guys are the only ones that know. Like, I've known them. But, and I didn't want to tell Lisa. If it weren't for Michael stopping me, I would still be up there performing.
Yeah. Mittens. I wear my baby mittens.
Unbelievable.
Sorry, buddy.
I got wiped out.
I did too. Not on purpose.
We'll take all that meat there, put it into walking up front. Hey, I got a whole bunch of food.
What?
Look, I got it right here.
All right, I'll clear out one of the sides of the walking.
We got to get it up now. Johnny Possepants really worked with me, but you know, we have one common goal, make Michael Ballard money.
Teamwork, baby, teamwork.
That's right. And we do it very freaking well.
We got a genie lift that up in the front, and now we don't have any damn light rig going across the front of the stage, and I got to try to figure out something. So, those lights that are on that inside bar down there, are they like fixed and now they won't come down?
We can pull them down from up there, but I don't really have any way of mounting them because it needs something like a truss or something round.
We're not using the kabuki, we'll just use that pole.
Okay, we'll see if we can do that.
Hey, before you take that apart, hold on a second. I was thinking about maybe just hanging some lights to it and pulling it up, so I got some front light across here. Good God, look at that thing of beauty. This will teach you to hang around with me. That's why they invented duct tape and a rock and roll attitude.
Every year we do a special ride in honor of Michael's sister, Vicky, who we lost 3 years ago to breast cancer. It starts in Trimble, Tennessee, the hometown of both Vicky and Michael, and it ends in Sturgis right at the Throttle. It's called the Vicky Ballard Memorial Ride, and people come from all over to be a part of this.
We're from Decatur, Illinois. We see you all the time down Daytona, and I wanted to make you your first baby girl. It's appropriate for boy or girl.
You're so crazy!
Oh, I wish I could yell to her, you're right, I'm pregnant! You're exactly right! But Michael and I have decided to kind of keep it under wraps.
Oh, look at it, it has flames and motorcycles on it. Oh, and you have something on there for Vicky.
On both sides.
Oh my gosh.
On both sides, I have the pink ribbon theme on both sides for Vicky.
This is truly an amazing gift. The minute I saw the pink ribbons on the blanket, I knew she was honoring Vicky.
Vicky's mama will completely appreciate that. Oh my gosh, that's my favorite part. Even if I don't never have a baby.
Oh, you can eat right here, motherfucker. Eat all you want over there.
Hey, come here.
What are we gonna do?
Hey.
First napkin.
Napkin right here. Wipe it on here.
Give her a little bit of lettuce. In her hand. Come on.
That's empty. You can leave it there.
No, you gonna throw that? No, throw that in his face.
Oh, I am?
Cause it's a Super Bowl tonight, so get ready.
Hey!
What's up, big man?
We're gonna make it rain!
really feel you.
The whiskey's here. The whiskey's here.
Thank God that shipment of Jesse James bourbon finally came in, and good timing too, because the crowds are starting to pour in.
You know, people are coming in droves right now, and there's not a doubt in my mind that I'm going to make up for a lot of lost ground tonight.
They've not got the back open yet. We want to get through the whole thing. They won't let us in the back right now.
What up? I'm about ready to kick that boy's ass out there. We're not letting your bike hard at all.
Yeah, but that guy didn't be on the...
You know, my guy is fuming because security has shut off the bikes from coming into the infield so that they can get to his burnout pit.
Is he over there now?
Yeah, he's got a green
shirt. Right here, too. That's why you ain't got no bike. Hey, I need that bikes in here.
We make a lot of money off selling tires to our customers so that they can get in the burnout pit and raise some hell. There is no reason that we should be making a mint right now.
Let him in there. I heard you some motorcycles.
There's just a few more pieces of this puzzle to put together for tonight's show. Is this the bike that I'm gonna be flying in on? I gotta go check on the chopper that I'm gonna be riding on as I make my grand entrance onto that main stage.
That'll work. I like that. What you think?
That'd be pretty easy to rig.
Right here under the front of this frame here, and then here.
Does this water valve work? Can I make bourbon come out of this?
Yep, that's what I'm for.
And I can pour some shots out of here?
Yes, sir. That's a given.
Hell yeah. This bike has a damn faucet on it. So I'm gonna be able to have bourbon pouring out of that thing as I'm flying through the air, and it's gonna be kick ass. Let me get a shot.
Do they not have a bartender up here? Are you kidding me?
Where y'all at? Y'all are late. Of all days for my Jesse James bourbon girls to not be up here. I've got all these people wanting to hang out, drink a little bourbon, get fired up, get primed up for the show, and they're nowhere to be found. Where y'all at? Y'all are late. Call me. Unbelievable. I finally get the bourbon in, and my Jesse James bourbon girls are MIA. While this stuff sells itself, it damn sure can't pour itself.
I need a bartender up in Club Papal.
I want the whole day to be perfect. It's the Jackal night here at the Full Throttle Saloon. I guess they laid out all night long with the guys in Vince Neil or something because they're running way behind schedule.
I found you a bartender.
Look at this.
Today in Club Papal, we're gonna call this Ladies' Day. So ladies, come on over here, right? We come here. Where's all my ladies at? Get up here, ladies. Ladies, what do you think? What do you like what I got you, girls? All right, there you go. I am in the business of turning negatives into positives. We'll flinch your muscle. There we go. I think it's a staple from here on out, Ladies' Day. I make you wiggle. Come on. Come on, there we go. There we go. Did you see what they did with that straight jacket?
Nope.
I know it's around here somewhere. They're always up to something. I love it. Hey, let me know whenever you get ready to do monitors. I'll come back up and check them out.
So, if he's saying he paid with 100, do we take it down and count it, or what do we do?
Yeah, we're gonna have to.
James came up to me and let me know that we had a customer at the front door that actually was claiming that he paid his $10 cover charge with a $100 bill, and he received no change back.
First of all, I'm Sean.
Hey, Sean.
Rodney. Rodney?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's gonna be $90.
Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run a report on it, and I'm gonna count the money that's in there. It gets busy, it gets hectic, and sometimes you do forget to give the change, and maybe you got his change, I don't know. Do you remember giving change or not?
Yeah, crazy, but
it's all good, man. Figure it out, right? I'll take this to the bank, we gotta give him some change, yeah.
Hey, what's
gonna
get you stunt? I got it all figured out.
What's that?
This straight jacket and one of Lynn's masterpieces. You will not believe what it's on tonight. It's gonna be good.
What about Penny and Thea?
Trust me, it's all good. You're gonna get what you wanted though, and it's gonna be badass.
You know, it's amazing to me how many people actually come out here and support the Vicki Ballard Memorial Ride in honor of my sister, Vicki.
It didn't separate.
Wow.
Oh, yay!
Wow, yeah, it turned out great.
This year, Michael's brother Cass had put together an image of Vicki in honor of Vicki and everybody else that has fallen to cancer.
Oh, it's great!
My sister, Vicki, worked with me for 20 years in my career. She was the backbone of me for that long, and this place has not been the same without her. She's a big reason this place exists right now. We want to make this a whole memorial wall for any people that come to this rally who have family and friends that have passed away from cancer. It's such a nasty damn thing. Anybody that has friends that want to come up here and put a plaque on the wall, pin up one of these pink ribbon and you know, in memory of their friends and family, we'd love for you to do that. So thank you guys for making the ride. Here's some beer for y'all.
I miss her dearly.
I miss her too.
With Angie being pregnant and me about to be a father, just it's unbelievable the importance now that I see in family that I didn't have before. I miss my sister, man. I really wish she was here to experience all of this with me.
It's been a shaky day all the way around trying to get ready for the show tonight, but it's looking like my crew is gonna make some magic happen. This bike that I'm gonna be flying in on is practically ready. Just a few more pieces and everything is good to go. What the hell are y'all doing?
Step away from the yeah. A really nice man on the internet offered to sell us a flamethrower pretty inexpensively.
Take it away from
him. Who doesn't like fire?
Say hello to my little friend.
Hey, hey,
you guys, what do you think, man?
I love it. Let's do it tonight. Hell yeah. What could possibly go wrong?
Fire, straight jackets, flying bikes, jackal jaws. Hell, Houdini ain't got nothing on me.
Sandwich here at the Throttle, baby.
The idea is all this product to leave the building. The product in the building makes us no money.
The grills went down. Couldn't think of anything worse to happen on the biggest night, Jackal Night, than the grills to shut down.
We're out of propane.
For his kitchen?
The grills went down. Couldn't think of anything worse to happen on the biggest night, Jackal Night, than the grills to shut down.
Do y'all have any propane tanks with propane in them down there? All right, I'm gonna send somebody down to get them. Okay, thank you. All right, we got a bunch of tanks down there that's full. Propane tanks? No, they're much short ones, but I got a bunch of them.
You know, us running out of propane in that main kitchen means our grills aren't going to run, our fryers aren't going to run, and no food's going to go across that counter. You know what that means? No freaking money.
Just so you see propane tanks on barbecue grills, take the tanks and bring them up.
No matter whose barbecue
grill. I don't care. They're my barbecue grills.
I need $90. I'm not sure how we're gonna do this. I need $90 of it, and then I need to find the guy and tell him we've screwed up.
Unfortunately, it was our fault. I mean, stuff happens. It happens out here as well. We make mistakes. It wasn't the customer trying to con us or anything.
I apologize. Our tail was $90.
I wasn't trying to read y'all.
I know you weren't. We get hectic out here.
Well, I'm glad you had a way to do it.
So, I apologize. You good? And then I have your $90 for you.
Thank you very much.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry that happened.
Thanks a lot.
You bet. You have a great time.
Okay? I will. Thank you very much.
Now, go ahead and feel free to spend all $90 of that
will.
In the bar, okay?
You'll get it back.
I mean, I'm giving it to you, but now you got to spend it.
We'll come back.
Okay.
We either get it at the gate or we're going to get it in the bar. One way or another, I'm going to have that $100 in Michael Ballard's pocket.
I hooked up a small propane tank, and it's only going to last a couple hours, but the disadvantage is there's no gauge on it. It's just going to die in the middle of the rush.
Look at the pilots going to start them.
Start running gas through the system. There's nothing like sitting there waiting, all of a sudden the fire goes on. It's an exciting moment. That's how we do it.
Hey, have y'all seen Lynn? Lynn.
So what the hell? What'd you get done? They tell me you were done with it?
Yeah. I got it done.
Yeah? How'd it turn out?
Well, it turned out great. I don't know how it's gonna turn out in the end.
Why are you saying it like that?
I don't know how it's gonna turn out in the end.
Holy
God! Hot damn, this thing is badass. Lynn has truly brought this thing to life, and I'm ready to find out if it's got some bite in it.
What's holding it up here now? The pin? This is holding it?
Yeah. Don't grab that because you're going to make money. Don't grab that.
I want to see what it does. The fact that it is.
God!
What's holding it up here now? The pin? This is holding it?
Yeah. Don't grab that because you're going to make money. Don't grab that.
I want to see what it does. The fact that it is.
God!
I don't know, man. That thing comes out pretty damn
fast. Are you sure you want to do this?
I'm in. We're past the point of no return. It's on. Thank you, Lynn. I got to go, man. I got to get the show together.
All right, Full Throttle. How y'all doing out there? Y'all having a great time? Make some noise. Come on. Holy crap, look at it. There's my new friend right there. He's a good friend of the Throttle. He just got tattooed. Him and his girl just got tattooed by the Full Throttle up there in the freeway. Oh, look what Danny's doing.
She said yes.
That's right there. Danny just proposed to his girl here at the Full Throttle Saloon Inn. She said yes. Now ask him for his wallet. Yeah. Everybody makes some noise for Danny right now. All right.
Boy, y'all knocked the hell out of this tent, huh?
Dude, it's crazy. They're slamming it out there. And tonight's going to be busy. It's just going to be huge tonight.
Have you ever had an insurance company give you a damn T-shirt?
Hell no.
The insurance for the crane and stuff, they need a signature from you because it's on your property.
Dude, I've been thinking about that. You know I'm going to be a daddy, right?
Is that just now sinking in?
No. It just changed me as soon as I seen that ultrasound. It's weighing on me. I don't.
Just, you ain't nothing you can do about it. This point,
I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about you doing that stunt tonight. I don't know that I want you to do it now. I just feel
no. Just come sign that paper.
I totally understand.
What the hell is this going? You lost your damn mind. I just can't believe you damn flip-flop on me like that. You made such a big deal out of me. Fucking jacked up. Don't even start backing up on that. Especially if you made a damn big stink like you did, but you're going to do it, and you got such a kick out of it. Please don't back up. Don't do that.
You know, I've been hit with family really hard today with, you know, the memorial ride for Vicky, Angie being pregnant. And Jesse's family to me. And for him to go run gung-ho into this stunt, I'm starting to have second thoughts about that. It's just too quick. It's not planned out correctly. And I just don't think he should do it.
I just understand it now. Knowing where I'm headed in my life and no one understanding where you've already been.
I went and talked to Penny. Everything's falling together. I busted my ass 6:30 this morning all day long trying to pull this day together. Liam busted his ass. He got everything together I needed done.
I understand that all that's taking place. I'm just telling you that that a realization now to me.
The realization is there's a damn crane sitting back there that I've been brought in. I've already paid for the son of a bitch and everything. I just need you to sign the paper that says it's okay for him to be on the property.
I'm gonna digest it for a minute.
That bull. You gotta be kidding me. I understand that Michael Ballard may be feeling the effects of his pending fatherhood, but he ain't gonna be messing with me now. I'll sign it. I swear to God, I'll sign it myself. You need to sign it so that we're covered, but if you don't, I swear to God, I'm gonna sign it.
I'll back it up.
That's bull. Don't even start that.
Next time on Full Throttle Saloon.
I've got one hell of a beginning and an even bigger ending.
Do you see that crane?
We have lightning strikes within 5 miles. No, that is within 2 miles.
A South Dakota storm could kill our whole entire night.
I don't give a f-.
Jesse has officially jumped the track.
Stop playing. No, don't look at me. Get off my stage. Turn that camera off of me. Are you kidding me?
It's Jackal Night.